going to last only 12 minutes. Remember the African history classes brought to you by the kind courtesy of Makbansi Perfumery. Now, Makbansi is an indigenous, ancient African fragrance and a space scenting company born in Ghana. It specializes in the production of high-end perfumes, candles, car scents, home and office diffusers and refreshers of the highest quality and longevity. Hey, it is housed to over 20 well-curated perfumes. Makbansi is also known for its compelling artistic concepts, intriguing packaging, and dramatic product names. Hey, listen, have you heard about the tropics of Mombasa? How about the spirit of Timbuktu? Oh my God. Now, the spirit of Timbuktu is a line of four different perfumes. And before then, let me just tell you that Makbansi seeks to retell the African story in scented products and, of course, perfumes. So when you wear any of the four different perfumes in the line of the spirit of Timbuktu perfumes, you are retelling the African story. Listen, number one is Indewura Jakpa, the founder of the Gonja Empire, the biggest empire in the whole Ghana today. Nefertiti, oh, she and her husband are Kenitan, aka Tutankhamun. In fact, were the founders of Abrahamism. Yes, the belief in one God. Now, we also have Dinga Cisse, the first king of the unified Ghana kingdom, whose capital moved from Kumbisali to August. And do you know that the Ghana Empire was such a powerful empire, so rich that not even a single person in the empire was considered poor? Everybody was rich. Can we have that kind of empire again today? The only empire in the world where nobody in that empire was ever seen as poor. My God, can this ever happen again? Think about it. So when Makbansi comes out with some of these interesting things, it is for you to spiritually leave these periods and also to be inspired to move on, to take your destiny into your own hands. Are you going for the Indewura Jakpa? I have that at home. Nefertiti, oh, I wear that. And my empress also wears that. Now, Nefertiti, oh my God, is for the ladies. It is so sexy. Oh my God, so beautiful. My brother, my sister, you can find Makbansi Perfumery inside North Legon, Wisconsin Road, inside the Cheesy Pizza building, or inside East Legon, Adrinkono, just after Kahaya. Oh my God, Kahaya. Why don't you call Makbansi right now on 0242-250-574. That is 0242-250-574. And Lawyer Tadio Sori is on his way to Kahaya. Yes, sir. Just after Kahaya, he would find Makbansi Perfumery, where he's going to buy all these scents: Ndewura Jakpa, Nefertiti, Dinga Cisse, and the citrus on the blast. He'll be going there after the class. This is it, the African history class. And my name, Blakk Rasta. I'm most excited to be with you, and this is how the class starts. But I see so many people write in the African history class. Now, you can also have your name mentioned in the class. All you need to do is to follow me on Twitter. Now, my Twitter handle is at Blakk Rasta. That's B-L-A-K-K-R-A-S-T-A. Yes, B-L-A-K-K-R-A-S-T-A. Also follow us on 3FM 92.7. When you follow us, you make sure that you also, oh my God, have mercy, tweet with the hashtags. Hashtag African History Class, hashtag Blakk Rasta, hashtag 3FM, hashtag Urban Blend, hashtag African History Class, and hashtag Taxi Driver Show. This is the African History class, and today I'm taking you all the way. In the interim, these are the students today in the class. Nat Ebubedike is our photo archivist right here in the African History class. I want to say thank you so much for joining us. We do appreciate you and we love you. Testament GH, I also see you right here in the class. We love you and we appreciate you. You see who I see? I see you, Lawyer Tadio Sori. Thank you so much for joining us, Ghana's number one lawyer. We appreciate you, Rasko Jotona, Michael Latrikivoju, a.k.a. Gumesika. Here you are also. Hey, TJ, all the way from Kia City, a.k.a. Kaswa. Black Lion, the General, I see you. All the way from Pram Pram, a.k.a. Blind Blind. Here you are also smiling at me. Rasko Tumfuwa Nanatu Tufalu Tujaja. Hey, 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 Tutumigo from...
Ya waleta matam sanga.
This is the African History class, and we have more people right here in the class. I see you, Your Lordship, Yoni Kulendi, right here in the African History class, Mr. Emil Short. I see you too. Former President of the Republic of Ghana, John Ajekum Kufuor, is right here in the African History class. I want to say thank you so much. I do appreciate you, and I do love you. Oh, my God. When I see people like this in class, I'm so happy. Nana Konedu Ajiman Rollins is also right here in the African History class. Shall we give them a standing ovation? Everybody. Everybody up on your feet.
Alexandria Waleta Matam Sanga. Yabo! Yabo!
This is the African History class, and I'm most excited to be with you. Many more people right here in the class. I see you, Nitaki. Thank you so much. I see you. Oh, oh, oh. The air conditioned man right in Nima. Oh, my God. Buhari, the AC specialist. Thank you so much for joining us. We do appreciate you. Many more people right here in the class. I want to say thank you so much to Chief Inspector of Police. Oh, Greater Accra Region. I'm talking about Chief Inspector Kwame Adanso. Thank you, Nat Ebubedike. One more time, we do appreciate you. I will love you, and you know that already, don't you? No, many more people right here in the African History class. Hey, see who is in class, my brother. Are you not the porn star everybody's talking about? Are you the one? Oh my God, I bet. So Sugar Titi is in class today, my brother, my sister, alongside. Ay, 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 the porn star. What's your name again, sir? This is the class. Francis Doku, I see you in the class. Thank you so much for joining us. We do appreciate you and we love you. Many more people right here in the African History class want to say thank you so much. I see you. Are you called Jean or Jean? Okay, thank you so much for joining us. We do appreciate you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And you say, I love the African History class. Thank you so much. We love you and we do appreciate you. Greater Ice is also in class. Thank you so much. We appreciate you. We love you. Many more people right here in the African History class. I want to say thank you so much. Hey, who is this? My brother, it's a long time. Where have you been all this while? Pato Rankin, right here in the African History class. I want to appreciate all of you. And I want to say thank you so much to all you wonderful people in class. Thank you. Oh, my God. I was going to ask you, what are you doing in Ghana? But, you know, I checked myself because this is your home as well. You know, this is Africa. Thank you so much. We do appreciate you. And King Lagazi, I see you. You celebrated your birthday a couple of days ago. Quick action. Thank you so much for joining us right here in the African History class. We do appreciate you. Kayleen Koko K, I see you. Empress Gessie B, I see you too. Thank you so much for joining us. Jigida Creation, Afigba Bavo, I see you here.
Alexandria Waleta Matam Sanga.
Royal Fellini, I see you. Thank you so much. And I see you too. Royal Stallion, Osman Withrago Moro. Thank you so much for joining us. We appreciate all you wonderful people right here in the African History class. I see you. Oh, Bongowela, I see you too. Thank you so much for joining us. This is the African History class.
Alexandria Waleta Matam Sanga. Yabo! Yabo!
And today, I'm taking you all the way from Africa down to Saint Dominic, all the way down, oh my God, to Haiti. My brother, my sister, Haiti and Saint Dominic were both French colonies so they speak predominantly French. My brother, my sister, our heroine for today came all the way from Senegambia. Her parents were captured as slaves and taken all the way first to Saint Dominique and then to Haiti, where she started a certain spiritual revolution. And this spiritual revolution can never, ever be underestimated. Today, my brother, my sister, if you are ready for the class, show my hands. Let me see those who are ready for the class. Show my hands. Everybody, show my hands. It looks like some people are feeling lazy in class. Everybody up on your feet. Everybody up on your feet. Up. You know how we do it here. Up. Okay, let's go. Up and up and down and up and down and up and down. To the left, to the right, to the left, to the right, to the left, to the right. And up. 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 This is the African History class, and I'm most excited to be with you. Sit down, students. Everybody sit down. Now, today we're telling the story of Cécile Fatiman. Cécile Fatiman. And Cécile is spelled C-E-C-I-L-E. Fatiman is F-A-T-I-M-A-N. And her story is about to blow your mind. Cécile Fatiman was born circa 1771. Over 200 years before I was born. My brother, my sister, today we're talking about Cécile Fatiman. Cécile Fatiman, and her photograph is right here on our Facebook page and also on Twitter. Now, those of you who are in the class, you can see the photograph. Such a beautiful black queen. Her story is about to blow your mind. Listen, and I need you to open your ears and listen with rapt attention. She was a powerful woman. She was born in 1771. And listen, she lived up to 112 years. How was she able to live this long when so many other people died around her in that revolution? Today, we are about to unravel the secret behind the power of this woman. Now, Cécile Fatiman was the daughter of an enslaved African woman coming all the way from Senegambia. In fact, she was enslaved by a Frenchman from Corsica. And this Frenchman raped her a number of times. And they gave birth to our heroine for today, Cécile Fatiman. When she was born, she had natural green eyes and silky hair, very woolly, silky, and long. She was always wearing a turban covering her hair. Her hair was like a very huge spiritual sacrament to her every time she tied it. She had green eyes. And look at the interesting thing. At a very young age, she was so interested in voodooism. And you know what voodooism is? Now, voodooism is from the word voodoo. And voodoo is a fun word or an ever word, which is the worship of the ancestors. Voodooism was what she was interested in. She dug deep into herself to find out exactly what it meant. Yes, to be spiritual. And she found her own spirituality, the spirituality of Loa, L-O-A. Yes, the goddess of Africa. Yes, from Dahomey and from the people of Benin. That goddess, very powerful, that could cause thunder and lightning. Oh my God. Today, my brother, my sister, at a very young age, she would go deep into the forest. And over there, she would be meditating and invoking the spirits of Africa. She started talking to spirits, and her mother thought she was going crazy. In fact, all this while she was in Corsica. Now, whilst in Corsica, there was a plan to move her from Corsica all the way to Haiti. Oh my God. But look at the interesting thing. Remember, her father was from Corsica. Yes, Corsica. Now, my brother, my sister, see what happened now. Interestingly, whilst there was a plan to carry her all the way from Corsica to Haiti, she was able to tell what it was going to be like. She could have resisted, but the spirit told her to move. And the spirit told her that she'll be able to make it happen. What? At that time, she and her mother were so close. She had two other brothers from the same white man who had enslaved their mother. And see what happened? She and her mother were carried all the way from Corsica, all the way into Haiti. But her two brothers were left behind. And they started to fight. They also found themselves in Haiti. And during the revolution, they got lost. Nobody knew where they were. But our heroine for today, Cécile Fatiman, stayed in Haiti. Where? Oh my God. She started a certain powerful voodoo movement. She got a lot of African people who had been enslaved to join her voodoo movement. Oh, they would worship. They would dance, they would sing, and they would slaughter animals, smear the blood of the animals on them whilst chanting. And each time, she would have a certain spirit, in fact, the spirit of Loa, L-O-A, possess her. And she would talk in strange languages and also prophesy. My brother, my sister, this is the original prophetess of Loa. My brother, my sister, interesting things about to happen. In August 1791, when she was only 20 years, our heroine for today, oh my God, presided over a ceremony at Bois Caiman. In French, we say Bois Caiman. Now, Bois Caiman was the site of the first major meeting of enslaved black people, during which the first major slave insurrection of the Haitian Revolution was planned. In fact, Bois Caiman, Bois is spelled B-O-I-S, and Bois in French simply means wood. Caiman is C-A-I, the I with the 2 points on top, M-A-N, Bois Caiman. In fact, so many black people met there. And then the prophetess of Loa came there. There was a huge bonfire that had never been seen. But they were allowed because their numbers were huge. And at the same time, they didn't seem to pose a threat to the slave master. And then they started beating drums alongside people like the Dotty Bookman, who had been brought all the way from the island of Jamaica. People like Jean-Francois Biasu, George, and Geno, all of them came together beating the drums, and this prophetess was chanting and singing. All of a sudden, the spirit of Loa entered her, and she started prophesying. Oh, she started prophesying. She prophesied that the leaders of the revolution were going to be Jean-Francois, Biasu, George, and Geno. These were the people the spirit said were going to lead the revolution, and asked them to go ahead and start a huge revolution against slavery in Haiti. That was what started the Haitian Revolution. Now see what happened. They slaughtered a lot of animals that day, including a pig. Some reports also said they even slaughtered some human beings, and they drank the blood right at the ceremony. Brother, my sister, they drank the blood of goats and sheep and also pigs. They also smeared themselves with the blood of the pig. And it was time for the revolution. What? Now, bullets that were shot at them never penetrated. No bullet ever penetrated their skin right after the ceremony. And they were able to move on and see what they did. They destroyed 1,800 plantations and set all of them on fire. 1,800 plantations. Can you imagine how huge this was? And each plantation had at least 1,000 acres of land. They destroyed and burnt 1,800 plantations. They also killed at least 1,000 slaveholders. They slaughtered them and killed them. The slave masters were unable to stop the revolution. They fired bullets and nobody was going down. Oh my God. And true to the prophecy, Jean-François Biasu George and Junot became the leaders of that revolution. Oh my God. Alongside Dottie Bookman, who later was arrested and slaughtered. My brother, my sister, this is the power of the African spirit. Now, this was what began the Haitian Revolution. Yes, before Louverture and the rest came into being. My brother, my sister, it was this woman who started that revolution. She mentioned who the spirits of Africa chose to lead the revolution. And they were those who led the revolution and even succeeded. Interestingly, she lived all the way to 112 years, marrying the very first, the very first president of Haiti, who reigned from the 16th of April in 1845 to the first day of March in 1846. And he was known as Louis Michel Pierrot. Today, my brother, my sister, we're talking the story of this great black woman. A black woman that I love, Cécile Fatiman. She used voodoo to start the liberation of slave people right there on the island of Haiti. The spirit of Loa she worshipped. In fact, after the bonfire, no bullet penetrated those who took part, and they were able to burn down 1,800 slave plantations, and 1,000 slaveholders were slaughtered and killed. And this was the beginning of the Haitian Revolution. She herself lived to see the end of the revolution and how the whole island was liberated. And she went ahead to marry the first president of the area. She died, my brother, my sister, in 1883. That was when she died. Today, we remember the powerful story of Cécile Fatiman, the little girl who was born right there in Corsica. Some other sources said she was born in Saint Dominique. She rose all the way to becoming the head of the Haitian Revolution. She worshipped the spirit of Loa, the African goddess. Oh, she was a powerful woman who no bullet ever penetrated. And whenever she went into, her element, she was able to prophesy, and all the prophecies came to pass. She was scared of nobody. People were rather scared of her. Today we remember you, mommy. Mommy, me see a kai kai. And we thank you, mommy. We thank you, mommy. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you, mommy. Oninyamin kowate. She lived to be 112 years old. May her body, mind, and soul rest in perfect peace as we remember her today. We do not know where she died and how she died. We do not even know whether she died or not, because nobody ever found her body. We remember this powerful black woman who broke the chains of slavery and freed tens of thousands of other slaves. She was the one who made the slave master, succumb. Today we remember you, Cécile Fatiman. Today we remember you. And in the building of knowledge, I ask you, now that you know what you do, biyane ni ole mini obafe yezunda kagane mezaka yine ye ipa bangu bukaya nungfifia ye nyanu kaina wo banayehu ebe deng lele anjima singa abe kune lele anjima singa abiri. It's been the African History Class. And my name, Blakk Rasta.
Mama mula ho meu, ao naima vinha.